Hello and welcome. What is CPUZ? CPUZ is a freeware system profiler application for Microsoft Windows XP, Vista, and 7. CPUZ detects and collects information on your system's central processing unit, CPU, random access memory, RAM, graphics video cards, motherboard chipset, and other hardware features common on computers. Windows does have a system information component that provides some of the same information, but it is nowhere near as robust or easy to use. In many cases, after using system information, you would still need to open your computer case to find out what was on the inside. This is largely eliminated with CPUZ. How to download and install CPUZ. Open a web browser like Internet Explorer. I have Google set as my homepage. If you don't have Google set as your homepage, enter www.google.com in the address bar and press enter. In the Google search field, enter CPUZ and press enter. The top link should be www.cpuid.com/software/cpu-z.html. Click on this link. On the CPUZ page, the downloads are available on the right side of the page. The easiest thing to do is just download the setup file. Some firewalls may block executable files. If this is the case, download the zip file, extract the executable, and then run it. Click the 1.59 Setup English link. On the Downloading CPUZ page, click the Download Now button. On the Download Information bar, you can save the file to your computer and then run it, but I prefer to just run the file. This means it will download the file and then automatically start the installer for us. Click the Run button. After the download finishes, the Setup CPUID CPUZ window will open. On the Welcome to CPUID CPUZ Setup Wizard screen, click the Next button. On the License Agreement screen, click the radio button to select I accept the agreement, and then click the Next button. On the Select Destination Location screen, you can change the installation folder if you like, or if not, click the Next button. On the Select Start Menu folder screen, click the Next button. On the Install the Ask toolbar screen, unselect all options and click the Next button. On the Select Additional Tasks screen, leave Create a Desktop icon checked and click the Next button. On the Ready to Install screen, review the information and click the Install button. On the Completing the CPUID CPUZ Setup Wizard screen, uncheck the option to view CPUZ underscore readme.txt and click the Finish button. How to use CPUZ? You can open CPUZ in one of two ways. Option 1, double-click on the CPUID CPUZ icon on the desktop. Option 2, click on the Windows Start button, All Programs, CPUID, CPUZ, and then the CPUZ icon. The CPUZ application window will open. Let's look on the CPU tab under Processor. Name. The name is the name of the processor, CPU, you have installed on your system. This is typically the name that the CPU is marketed under. You could search for exactly what is listed under the name in Google or another search engine to find a replacement or reviews. In my case, I have an AMD Phenom 2 X3-720. Codename. This is the name of the processor core architecture. Max TDP. TDP stands for Thermal Design Power. This is the maximum amount of power that the processor will use. In my case, the max TDP is 94 watts. Package. Package shows the name of the motherboard socket your processor is designed to fit in. In my case, the package is a socket AM3, 938. This means that I use AMD socket AM3, which is made up of 938 pins. If you wanted to replace your processor, you could now go to the internet and shop for a new socket AM3 processor. Any one designed to work in socket AM3 could be dropped into the computer. Technology. Technology shows the processing geometry used to create the processor. In this case, it is 45 nanometer. This means the processor was built using a 45 nanometer or NM process technology. 1 nanometer is 1 billionth of a meter. The smaller the process technology used, the more transistors that can be packed into the available space. This allows processors to become faster and use less energy with every generation. Core voltage. The core voltage is the power supply voltage supplied to the CPU. This, along with max TDP, is often important to individuals who are overclocking their computers. In this case, the voltage is 1.411 volts. Specification. Specification shows the processor information, and in many cases is the exact same name as the name field from above. Family and extended family. This section refers to stepping information for the processor. This is used to determine the revision of the processor. Once a processor goes into production, as time goes on, minor updates and bug fixes are made to the processor. Each update is a new revision, or stepping. You could use this to see if your processor revision is the one with or without a bug. Instructions. Instructions refer to instruction sets that the computer is capable of running. This is the basic set of commands or instructions the processor is capable of understanding. In this case, this processor supports MMX, 3D Now, SSE versions 1, 2, 3, 4A, x86-64, and AMDV. Under clocks, it shows the core information of one of the processor cores. All cores are identical. Core speed. The core speed is the frequency that the processor is running at. In this case, it shows 3110.5 MHz. Modern computers are speed rated in gigahertz, not megahertz. 1000 megahertz is equal to 1 gigahertz. So this processor is running at 3.11 gigahertz. The processor speed is determined by taking the speed of the CPU bus and then multiplying it by the multiplier. HT link. This processor is an AMD processor, so it has the HT link or hyper transport link. If you had an Intel processor, it would show QPI link or Quick Path Interconnect link. These links are the system bus that connects the various components of the computer. Under cache, it shows information on the cache on the processor. CPU cache is used to reduce the average time to access the memory. The cache is memory that is faster than main memory and is directly inside the CPU package. Cache stores copies of the most frequently used data from main memory. Each core has its own 64 kilobit level 1 data cache, 512 kilobyte level 2 cache, and all cores share a 6 megabyte L3 cache. At the bottom it shows this processor has 3 cores and can run 3 threads. Some processors have hyper-threading, which allows them to run 2 threads on each core instead of 1. We can skip the caches tab for now, as it is the same information we just covered. The mainboard tab provides information on the motherboard. Manufacturer. Here you will see the manufacturer of the motherboard. In this case, it is made by Asus Tech Computer Incorporated. Model. The model of the motherboard is listed here, along with a revision number. This is an M4A78T-E. This is extremely useful in determining what drivers to download. The chipset is an AMD 790GX with an AMD 7B700 Southbridge. The chipset controls communication between the processor and other devices on the motherboard. BIOS. BIOS stands for Basic Input-Output System. The BIOS initializes and controls the devices on the computer at the hardware level. Under the BIOS section, it lists the manufacturer of the BIOS, along with the version and the date of the installed BIOS. If it's old, there is probably an update that might improve performance or fix bugs that could be downloaded at the motherboard manufacturer's website. In this case, the BIOS is manufactured by AMD Megatrends. It's version 2208 and was created on 10/28/2009. You would download this at the page of the motherboard manufacturer, not the BIOS manufacturer. Under Graphic Interface, it shows that the graphics interface for this computer is a 16x PCI Express slot. The next two tabs, Memory and SPD, provide information on the system memory, or RAM. Let's look at memory first. Let's look under the General section. Type. Here the memory interface type is listed. In this case, the memory is DDR3. DDR stands for Double Data Rate. Size. Here you will find listed the total amount of memory in the system in megabytes. 1024 megabytes is 1 gigabyte. So this system has 4096 megabytes, or 4 gigabytes of memory. Channels number. Channels refers to the number of channels available to the memory controller. A dual channel configuration has double the bandwidth of single channel memory. Triple channel has 3 times, and so on. DC mode. This will either be ganged or unganged. With a ganged setup, all cores get access to all sticks of RAM. While in unganged mode, each core gets access to its own memory. In most cases, ganged mode is better for single-threaded applications, and unganged mode is better for multi-threaded applications. NB frequency. This is the speed of the system bus, or hypertransport link. This is the same as the HT link on the CPU tab. Timings table. DRAM frequency is the memory clock speed. DRAM stands for Dynamic Random Access Memory. In this case, it is 533 MHz. This is double data rate memory, so you can double that, making this memory DDR3 1066, running at 1066 MHz, or just over 1 GHz. The rest of the information on this page is related to CAS latency. CAS latency is complicated to understand. Basically, it's a measurement of the time between the moment a memory controller tells the memory module to access a particular memory column to the moment data is available at the RAM's output pins. As a general rule, the lower the CAS latency, the better. The SPD tab contains additional information about the memory. Under Memory Slot Selection, if you click the drop-down, you will get a list of each of the memory slots in the motherboard. In this case, there are 4 slots available for RAM. Selecting each one will provide information regarding the memory in that particular slot. Slots 1 and 2 in this system each have a stick of RAM in them. Slots 3 and 4 are empty. This means I have 2 slots available for expansion. The memory type is DDR3. Module size. This is the amount of memory on this one RAM module, not the entire system. This is 2048 megabytes, or 2 gigabytes. Maximum bandwidth. The module name is listed here. In this case, it is PC3-8500F, clocked at 533 MHz. If you are upgrading memory, you would want to buy this memory standard can be compatible. Manufacturer. Here, as the name suggests, you would find the name of the memory manufacturer. In this case, the memory is made by OCZ. Part number. This is the manufacturer part number for the memory installed in the selected slot. We'll skip the timings table. The Graphics tab contains information regarding the graphics or video card installed in the system. Name. Here is the retail name for the graphics card. In this case, it is an AMD Radeon HD 4850. This is how the product would be listed at, say, a Best Buy. Code name. This is the code name for the graphics core inside the video card. In this case, the core is a RV770. Technology. This is the same as the technology field on the CPU tab. This is the process geometry used in the manufacturing process. In this case, it is built on the 55 nanometer node. Let's look under the memory section. Size. This is the size of the memory, in megabytes, on the graphics card, not the memory in your computer. This system has 512 megabytes. Bus width. This refers to the width of the interface connecting the graphics chip to the memory on the graphics card. In this case, the bus width is 256 bits. You should now have a good general understanding of the various information you can find using CPUZ and how it can be beneficial to you.